What we see here is the what we call the moving load simulator. It's the first and the only one, in fact, in Canada. What it does here is it tests the fatigue behavior of bridges in a realistic way. So as the heavy trucks or vehicles pass on the bridge, they push down on the bridge and you create what we call bending and shear stresses. In real life, this traffic, it's cyclic in nature, meaning it comes and goes, right? So you have a load passing over the bridge and then it disappears on the other side, another wave of traffic comes on and so on. As it turned out, the way we do it now, loading and unloading on the same spot, we call it pulsating loading. Pulsating loading is quite different in nature from the real cyclic loading on the bridge. The number of cycles it takes to failure, we call it fatigue life. And that translates into the number of years of service you can get out of this bridge.
The need for it is that there's a lot more people shifting towards the long-term behavior of these bridges, and that's why we have a machine which is able to cycle for months at a time, simulating the whole lifetime of a bridge in as short as a couple of months.
No tests to date have looked at a full-scale wheel load on a full-scale bridge deck, and we believe that this will allow us to make a more representative vehicular loading scenario on the bridge decks, which will allow us to gain an improved understanding of bridge deck behavior. And this will in turn allow contractors and companies to design better bridges.